Hi, hello. Welcome to another Shower Doctor live chat. If you've got any questions about showers, just send them in and we'll do our best to answer them. We've got Lucas in the background here working the technical stuff, and me about to explain a little bit about flow valves in the shower. Flow valves are quite an important part of the shower. It's what controls the water that goes through it. So I've got a Triton shower here. So the water would normally come in here past the solenoid valve. Not every shower's got a solenoid, and then through the flow valve, and it's that regulates the water that goes into the heating tank. I think, though, probably what I need to explain is what a flow valve really is. It's effectively a tap. This is really the inside of a tap, and you can see that we've got a washer here. And what happens is that when you turn the tap on and off, the washer goes back and forward into the hole, and so into the face of the tap, and so as it comes back out, it allows more water to go through. The more modern one is, of course, a ceramic disc that has holes in the end, and it turns on and off. The problem with these things is that when it comes to a shower, they're not accurate enough to meter the water properly as it goes through the shower. So what we have then is we've got to get to the kind of more complicated valves that go into the shower. This is a fairly cheap valve, and you can maybe recognise the washer that's in the same as an ordinary tap. And what that does is it goes against the face like so, and it turns as you turn it on and off, the washer moves back and forward. But slightly differently with this is it has this cone-shaped thing here. You probably won't be able to see it, but there are flutes on the cone, and as you open the tap, the flutes are held, the volume of water is curtailed with a rubber ring. And as it comes out, the flutes get bigger, so you can then meter the water much more carefully. This is a Triton valve, really. It's a stabiliser valve as well as a flow valve. And what happens in here, there's a couple of springs inside this and a diaphragm. That means that when you've sort of set the temperature of your shower, that if somebody flushes a toilet or opens a tap somewhere and the pressure in the system changes, because of the springs in the diaphragm, it tries to meter. It's not perfect, but it tries to keep the flow a little steadier than it would normally do with this sort of thing. And it's the springs that help to do that. We've got a Myra one here. This is a Myra flow valve that's used in the Sport and one or two of the other models. Same sort of thing, that you turn the water, you adjust the water flow here, and it's adjusted inside this little box. This is a completely sealed unit that's glued together. There's nothing you can do. If this becomes faulty, it's a case of replacing the complete flow valve. There's quite a few replies coming to some of the videos, and maybe I'll answer one or two of the questions. Cecil Chan emailed in and said, after replacing our Moen cartridge on the shower, we finally had hot water, but there is now a water leak where the knob and the round plate meet. Could this be a defective cartridge? I don't know, Moen, there's quite a few different cartridges, so I don't know exactly which one you have. To be honest, the cartridges seldom leak. You sometimes can get, not very often, but you can occasionally get a cartridge with a temperature control problem. If it's a leak, I suspect it really that one of the O-rings has rolled back when you've fitted it, or indeed you maybe nicked one of the O-rings. I guess the best thing to do is to take the cartridge out again, make sure the O-rings are okay, they've not been nicked in any way, give them a coating of grease, and then push them back in. When you push a cartridge back in, whichever type of cartridge it is, really always try and make sure you go in nice and square. Don't just shove it in any old way, because it's that causes the O-rings to roll back. Just to be careful when you're putting any cartridge in that you get it in straight. Now there's somebody here with their name is VXIGSI, so I don't know how to pronounce that, but it asks how you test a latching switch because his shower has no water. There are two types of latching switch. One, when you press it, it stays in, and then you press it again and it pops back out. So when it makes a connection, and when you press it again, the connection it breaks the connection. The other type is that when you press it in, it makes a connection, and then electronically the shower is switched on, and then you press another switch or whatever to switch it off, but it really just turns the power on to the shower. The way to test them would be to test them for continuity across the switch. However, to be honest, usually you can feel it if it's clicking in or not clicking in properly. It's a feel thing. You can generally, you know, do it by touch. You may actually have to take the front cover off the shower to actually, because the button generally connects onto the latching switch. So you may actually have to take the cover off and press it. If you're taking the cover off, of course, remember to switch the power off first. However, when you said here that the shower has power but won't turn on, I suspect that really what you've got is a faulty solenoid rather than a faulty latching switch. So it may very well be to look at our video. We've got a video on how to test solenoids. This thing here, you should be able to recognise it in your shower. They're all roughly the same, different colours, but you should be able to recognise that. We've got a video on how to test them. So I would check that your solenoid isn't a problem, because that's the most likely thing. I see there's a live chat coming here from Gordon McDonald. He's a 20-year-old Myra 415 that's developed a drip. Any suggestions? Yeah, it needs a cartridge. We have cartridges for the old 415. 415 is a great shower. It's connected, usually used for connection to a combi boiler. And the 415 was one of the first of the valves, 20 years old, I shouldn't be admitting that, but it was one of the first of the valves that were actually designed around a combi boiler. And so it can alter the pressure from either side. So if the pressure in the hot or cold goes up, it's got a balancing thing inside that that keeps the pressure fairly level and steady. Andy Jenner here, I've just changed the solenoid, but still nothing. He's got a Triton Aspirante. If it's not the solenoid, then what else? But I guess normally when you have showers, no water coming through, the common fault is a faulty solenoid. But really, before you change it, you want to test it for resistance. Having said that, if you have changed it, the next thing to do is to check and make sure you're getting power actually coming to the solenoid. I mean, as you can see with this solenoid, we've got a live and a neutral connection. Just make sure there's actually power getting to it. What can happen is that if you have a faulty microswitch, then I don't know if you can see this properly, the microswitches are in here in the shower, but if you have a faulty microswitch, then it may be that the power's not actually getting to the solenoid. Sometimes it may actually just be the knob that's not clicking on properly at the back of the cover, and not allowing the microswitch to switch on. And if that's not switching on, there's no power getting to the solenoid. My Gainsborough shower is making a squealing noise when first switched on. Would a cartridge cure that? Yes and no. What usually tends to happen with a shower that's making a squealing noise is, first of all, the cartridge is getting old. And if it hasn't squealed before. But the squealing noise usually happens when you've got high pressure cold and low pressure hot. And so to make the shower balance properly, the hot port inside the shower is fully open and the cold port is only open a crack. And what you're actually hearing is the water getting forced through this crack at high pressure, and that's what makes it squeal. A brand new cartridge, people, you know, it's very easy to say, yes, a brand new cartridge, you sort that. But there is the odd time that it's not the cartridge, it's just the amount of pressure differential that's making it squeal. Usually, a cartridge will solve the problem, but the problem really is more than that. There's a problem with the installation. The pressures are too far apart, and that's what's making it squeal. So that's it. Just subscribe to our channel, and thank you for watching.